Hello, this is the RPG Chick. Welcome back to Let's Play the Book of Unwritten Tales 2. We're going up into the throne realm to...
Nothing for it. Have to talk to Pa.
I didn't know we had to talk to him. We need to figure out about the magic mirror thing.
Ivo, I thought that we'd agreed that you would stay in your room.
I didn't agree. You just locked me in. I will not get any slimmer sitting around in my room.
I just left my room to do a bit of training.
Mm-hmm.
You said yourself I've put on a few pounds, and I'm not going to get rid of them by lying around on my bed all day.
Where does this sudden insight come from?
From my arse.
I can't keep asking myself what to do with my life. Perhaps marriage isn't such a bad idea.
It most certainly isn't. And if you train diligently, I'm sure Prince Lalilos will like you a lot.
Of course. Fine.
I would love to help you, but I'm most dreadfully busy. A kind of epidemic seems to have broken out in Seastone.
An epidemic in Seastone?
Strange. We're getting reports from the whole of the Middle Kingdom. Objects and beings have been... changed.
Changed?
What do you mean?
Are they pregnant?
The situation isn't clear. It appears as if some kind of terrible power is gradually moving through the whole land, changing it. Do you remember the story of the Nothing? A big blackness that gradually swallowed a fairy kingdom bit by bit.
Of course.
This time it is much worse. It is pink.
Is that never-ending story? Or am I thinking of...
epidemic in Seastone. Is it wise for me, and it, to go there? On the other hand, Wilbur and the Archmage in Seastone. Perhaps I can help them to fight the epidemic in exchange for them helping me with my problem.
Perhaps.
I can blame Mother for a lot of things, but not laziness. On the contrary, she does the same work as three people put together. Because she doesn't trust anyone to do it as well.
Anything else to say to her?
Mother?
I'm very busy, my dear.
Yes, Ivadora.
Ivadora? That's her name? Not Ivo? Do you really think that I look fat? This is a loaded question.
Do you really think that I look fat?
You aren't really fat, my darling, but you aren't perfect either.
Do I have to be perfect?
No one is perfect, but that doesn't stop us striving for it. Once you are happy with yourself, then you become overindulgent.
So we can never be happy with ourselves.
Satisfaction can take you far, my darling.
Sounds like some life. Do you really believe that this prince suits me?
Why do you want me to marry this particular prince?
Because I think that will be best for you.
And if I don't like him?
Then you will learn to love him.
Why can't I fall in love first and then marry?
And what happens if you don't fall in love? You won't ever marry then? Don't be childish, Ivadora.
Right. Can we do something about the epidemic in Seastone?
Do you know what can be done to fight the epidemic in Seastone?
Done? Nothing, my darling.
Here's our symbols.
It's a matter for humans. We will only observe.
How hard would it be for us to actually help solve a problem for once, instead of waiting for it to solve itself?
If Alistair needs my advice, he can ask me, and up to now he has not done that.
But...
I'm not going to interfere.
See you later, Mother.
Don't pull a face like a wilted willow, Ivo. Smile.
Leave her to work. This magical epidemic seems to be really worrying her.
Alright, so what things can we look at around here? There's those three symbols, and that's Father, right? The king, yep. The moon well.
Only priestesses are allowed to get water from the well. Up to now, my mother hasn't tried to make me into a priestess. If I'm lucky, she never will. Only priestesses up to now.
There's that stone tablet. Or one of them.
This symbol's on the bottom of the mirror bowl in the garden. No idea what it means. That's Mother's area of expertise.
So one has a line below, one has a line above, and this one has circles around it.
This symbol's on the bottom of the mirror bowl in the garden. This symbol's on the bottom of the...
Look at the king.
Pa doesn't like getting up early. He always says he needs lots of sleep. But he's never said why.
Wake up, Dad.
Hey, Pa. The day started ages ago.
What? Oh, Ivo. How's my favorite daughter?
A bearded elf?
I'm your only daughter.
Oh, that I had 100. You are and will remain something very special. The other 99 would be as well, though.
Pa, you're nuts.
It's like covered with roots. It's a wonderful day today, isn't it?
Isn't it a wonderful day today? Again.
Small talk.
Just as the caterpillars cough in the morning dew.
Yeah, they do.
Yes. Something seems to be troubling.
Nah, nothing. Mother is treating me like a small child.
She locked me up like a small child.
Have you argued again?
She started it.
She loves you.
And she only wants the best for me. How can it be best for me if she constantly criticizes me and forces me to do things that I don't want to do?
She believes that this will help prepare you for the life that awaits you.
I'd just like to decide for myself.
I know. Your mother just doesn't understand that, because she never had that choice.
Do you want me to marry this prince too?
Mother wants me to marry this Prince Lalilos.
I did hear about that.
Is that your wish, too?
All I wish for is for you to be happy.
Well, that won't make her happy.
Ah, so I'm not going to marry him.
Fortunately, not all wishes are granted.
Nah.
Oh.
You are an elf princess. You will need to marry sooner or later. It's just when and who. I'd rather just leave that to Mother Nature.
I wish you could convince Mother of that.
I fear her faith in your taste in men has been shaken a little since. Well, you know, she wants to prevent your heart being broken again. That's why she is choosing someone that she thinks is right for you.
Don't always defend Mother.
Doesn't Mother's way of doing things drive you a bit mad?
Naturally.
Then why don't you tell her?
Does the gnu talk of spring when the shadows are tickling the squirrel?
Maybe?
I love her. It's just a phase. She'll change. And if she doesn't change, then I will not love her any less. I love you both as you are. Warts and all.
It's like, I don't have warts. Would you have used the artifact of divine fate?
Pa, would you have used the artifact of divine fate, or would you have hidden it like we did?
I think that too much power can corrupt any one of us.
Right.
But you have great powers, and you've never used them for evil.
I could have cured diseased woodlands with the artifact, cleaned rivers in the air. And then what? Then I might have chased away the lumberjacks and destroyed the factories of the dwarves.
I could have helped a lot of humans.
Things take time, Ivo. If you force change before its time's come, then it won't last.
I'll say this for last. Enlighten me, Father. About what?
Enlighten me, Father.
The moth and the dandelion loved by me like very little else. Anger the humanless gods.
They do?
I'll need to have a think about that.
Oh, is this random sayings?
Enlighten me, Father.
The striped kakadu and the limping squirrel, loved by me like very little else, bring the little llama to tears.
Huh.
Understood.
I'll do a few more. You know what it is? It's these three lines. They'll get interchanged.
Enlighten me, Father.
Wide sky and the burning sun, denied by those who are unaware.
Yeah, that's the second line.
They may be clever, but they are not wise.
That is interesting. Enlighten me, Father.
The striped kakadu and the limping squirrel, laughing madly and turning quickly in circles, are amongst the greatest wonders of the world.
I'll need to have a think about that.
One more.
Enlighten me, Father.
Ghosts and demons,
ooh,
laughing madly and turning quickly in circles, are a wonderful sight.
I think so.
I'll need to have a think about that.
So, Father, I'm pregnant.
I need to tell you something, Father, but I'm not sure how.
Baby, inside. Dun, 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 dun.
It's not good for the baby.
You know.
Has a zebra got stripes?
Normally.
How can it have happened? Why?
I don't know. Is that important?
It is. I want to know what's happened to me.
Then look for the answers, my little bud.
How can you be so calm about it?
Because I know that everything will be fine in the end.
I think he's calm about everything.
And if it isn't fine?
Then it is not the end.
Right. I have to go to Seastone to visit the Archmage.
If you don't know what the pregnancy's all about, then I'll have to travel to Seastone and ask the Archmage.
The fact that I don't know means that you did not get pregnant by natural means. And if something does not conform to the laws of nature, then it must be magic.
Right.
No one knows more about these things than Alistair.
True.
We agree then.
Like snails munching cabbage. Only your mother isn't going to permit it.
I know, but I'll work on that.
Oh, we simply just won't tell her. See you later.
I've got quite a lot to think about.
Goodbye, little daughter.
See you later, Father.
We got fishing in this water. What are you looking at? So we can talk to her one more time before we go back down.
Mother?
Yes, Ivadora.
How did you and Pa meet?
When you married Father, how long had you known each other?
Just a few days. I fell in love with him instantly. He was the wisest and most handsome elf that I had ever met.
And if you hadn't loved him, or if perhaps you hadn't even liked him...
Then I would have married him anyway. It is the duty of the princess to secure royal succession.
Whether she wants it or not...
You didn't want to go to school either. Today you can play music, paint, speak a dozen different languages, and have realized what a gift education is. Please, just trust me. Sometimes only parents know what's best.
Until now. What do the symbols on the stone tablets mean?
Those symbols on the columns, what do they mean?
First your insights concerning your wedding, and now an interest in the spiritual. You do surprise me.
Well, I have questions about stuff.
These symbols depict the three different forms that water takes. They are important in many rituals. Water that falls from the sky. water that springs from the earth.
And ice?
And water that is bathed by moonlight.
Okay, that's not ice. What is meant by different forms that water takes?
What's all this different forms of water all about, then? You told me earlier about the different forms of water. Mm-hmm. What does it actually mean?
It's about 5 seconds ago.
Not all water is the same. It changes. If it bubbles out of the spring, then it is spring water. Then it turns into stream water, perhaps into river water, and then sometimes later into sea water.
Mm.
The voice of water changes, its soul.
And if different forms of water are mixed together,
then you can create water with powerful magical properties. But it's not as easy as you might imagine. Water is constantly changing its form. Rain is water from the sky, but as soon as it lands in a puddle, then it becomes common puddle water.
See you later, Mother.
Don't pull a face like a wilted willow, Ivo. Smile.
Interesting. Anything else to say, just in case?
I'll leave her to work.
Okay, I'll take that as enough.
This magical epidemic seems to be really worrying her.
Let's try Father more. I wonder if we can talk to him about the different ways, different forms of water.
Pa?
Yes, Poppet?
Oh, never mind.
I've got quite a lot to think about.
Goodbye, little daughter.
See you later, Father.
Does he ever move, or is he always just ensnared in roots? Different forms of water, huh?
There's only a little water left in the bird bath. I, however, think that the constant need to replenish...
Oh, that's the magical thing. I wonder if Arbor would know anything about this different forms of water.
I could ask him right now.
About different forms of water, you silly thing. Let's look at the symbols.
Water that has spilled from the earth. Water that has been bathed by moonshine. Water that has fallen from the sky. They're the same symbols as in the throne room.
Mm-hmm.
Water that is... They're the same... I don't know what I could ask.
Interesting. Well... Apparently this is what we have to do next, is mix forms of water. I wonder if we could get some insight in the library.
The willow is stretching its... One part of the waterfall's already locked. Hey, Cheap. I'll be back soon, Cheap. I wish there was something to indicate that the book... I'm pregnant. I just know...
Book on fishing. I don't think it's going to be anything new.
No, I need a bit more practical experience in fishing before the book will help me.
That's funny, her fishing went up to 1. I wonder if we're going to have any more use for fishing.
That's just what I need.
Okay, to collect different forms of water.
Empty.
Okay, well, oops, I didn't mean to do that. Ta-da! Okay. There's no water in here. stuttering. I'm used to going to the bottom to get to the items. That's what it is. Okay, so has this bathed in moonlight?
Water, straight from the waterfall.
Pour it into the pond. Pretty sure this isn't what we're supposed to do, but I just want to see.
There appears to be an amazing collection of stuff accumulated in the little pond. I wonder if there's anything there that could prove useful. Empty. Shame that the tree's casting more and more shade over the waterfall. Before, the sunlight used to dance on it.
Yeah. Just use it on there. No. Thank you. I don't want to look at the bird bath, I just want to walk. And walk. There we go.
Water from the waterfall. One could also say, water that has fallen from the sky.
Right, true.
It works. One of the symbols is glowing.
Cool. Yeah, I was going to wonder how we were going to do that, if we had to go to some other land to do that, because it doesn't rain here, ever. How about... no. Okay. I suppose we can reach that. Nope. Come on. Girl, move. Girl, move.
If that isn't water bathed by moonshine, then I don't know what is. The only problem is, Mother guards this water like treasure and stands directly next to it.
Well, she's not watching.
If that isn't water, the only...
Oh, I had to distract her. Throw worms at her or something. We could fish in it. Can we scare her with this? Scare father with that? So how do we stop her from standing next to it?
Mother?
Yes, Ivadora.
I would like a bit of the moon water.
By moonlight,
it's not going to let us take it.
Of course it is, my darling. Could I take some of it? It is holy water. We only use it for special occasions. What do you need it for?
None of your business. I am thirsty?
I'm thirsty, and I thought to myself, I've never tried moonwell water.
Well, keep thinking.
Huh?
This water is not intended for such profane use.
Profane? It's drinking. About the moon water?
About the moon water. What do you need it for?
I want to mix a potion with it. It's an important ingredient.
I need it for a potion. It's one of the most important ingredients.
Really? What sort of potion?
A slimming potion. What? I want to blow as much air as possible into the water and then sell it for lots of money?
I just think that one could sell water with lots of bubbles in it for much more money than pure water.
What a strange idea. Why don't you just take normal water? Anyone falling for that will never know the difference.
About the moon water,
what do you need it for?
It's for a ritual.
I'd like to carry out a ritual. I need some water that has been bathed by the moonlight for it.
Really? What sort of ritual?
It is a surprise?
Well, I want to, well, it's a surprise.
I don't like surprises, especially not when it concerns magic rituals. What sort of ritual are you planning?
Then it wouldn't be a surprise. I want to become at one with the cosmos, to see the future and the past.
I want to become one with the cosmos and nature, and, to see the future and the past. So do the things that you do.
Child, you'll need centuries of training for that. Only priestesses can use moonwell water for spiritual journeys.
About the moon water,
what do you need it for?
Ritual?
I'd like to carry out a ritual.
Really?
Really? I want to cast a spell over the mirror so that it can hopefully answer some of my questions.
Well, it's just, really...
What do you want to use the water for?
I'll forget it. About the moon water.
What do you need it for?
Potion?
I need it for a potion.
Really?
It is meant to be a beauty potion.
Well, the moon water is a particularly pure and clean water.
Probably that last one.
I thought it could form the basis of a beauty potion.
It is true that this water is purported to have healing powers.
I didn't want to trouble you with this, but then I thought, if I'm meant to be looking my best for the prince, then such a potion wouldn't do any harm.
Maybe this'll work. There you go.
Oh, absolutely. Do you have a vessel?
Absolutely.
May the moonwell water give you the help you need to become more beautiful, just as it has always helped me.
To boot, it couldn't help with your personality. More moon water.
See you later, Mother.
Don't put a face like a...
Yeah. Okay, so we need to go to the garden. A quick stride. That's the way you do it. Now I forget what that last one was.
Right. Now water that has been bathed in moonshine. That must mean the water that's come from the moon well. Aha! That's got the second symbol to glow.
Okay, so what's that last one?
Water that's fallen from the sky. Water that's been bathed by moonshine. Two symbols are glowing. Only one to go.
It's the last one.
Water that's... Water... Two...
Water. I can't remember that last one. Seawater? Hold on.
Droplet signifies water, the circle, the moon. Water that's been bathed in moonshine.
Right, have that.
The symbol for water that falls from the sky.
And here's the one we're looking for, then.
Water that spills from the earth. That's what this symbol means, according to Mother. And she knows what she's talking about.
Spills from the earth. Well, you'd think if it came from the Earth that Arbor could know about that. I like the way she walks. I'm not sure if he's going to have anything new to say. Time, I see.
What can I do for you?
I need a certain kind of water.
I need a special sort of water, Arbor. Can you help me?
A special sort of water? Now who's been dreaming that stuff up?
My mother.
Arbor, please help. I need water that spills out of the ground.
There,
spring water.
As much water as you want.
Well, it's not that simple. That water's changed. I need water directly out of the earth.
Spring water.
You elves always like to make things complicated, don't you?
Hmm.
You got a container?
Right. Sure do.
There you go.
What'd you do?
And don't start telling me that this is some kind of snot water or the like. This be tip-top quality groundwater.
Should work. Thank you.
Did he like...
I have to get on. Don't work too hard.
Did he pee in it or something?
Water spilled from the earth and channeled through the nose of Arbor.
The nose.
Gross.
It came from his nose. Okay, so we got snot water. Okay, here we go.
Let's hope that Arbor's donation of water that spills from the earth will work. It hasn't really spilled from the earth, but it is groundwater, and it's never seen the sun.
Hmm. Hope so.
Now all the symbols are gone.
Yay!
Hello? Are you there?
I'm always there.
Hmm. My first magical incantation. Not bad.
I cast a spell over you single-handedly, with no help.
You had help, you just didn't realize it.
Had help from Arbor? Mother?
No, I did it by myself.
I'm the All-Knowing Seer. I'm telling you, you are wrong.
Hmm. Are you really All-Knowing?
Are you really All-Knowing?
No, but it sounds better than I am the seer who saw more than any other being in the world and yet didn't see all.
And who exactly are you? And where are you?
I did summon you, but I don't really know anything about you. Do you live in the water, or are you the water?
No, the water is just a reflective surface. I live on the other side of the mirrors.
Hmm.
I see what happens in front of mirrors. To you, they are simple reflections. To me, they are the window through which I view your world.
Oh, through all water?
Okay.
Whoever the voice is sees through all water, which is reflections when we look at it. Well, when it's still, anyway. Are you also in my bedroom mirror?
So you live on the other side of all mirrors. Does that include the one in my bedroom?
Yes, mirrors and...
I can look through any reflective surface.
Right.
I see all.
You do close your eyes, when it's the decent thing to do, right?
Hmm.
I see all.
No, that's not the answer he wanted.
Yes, understood. But if someone's undressing in front of their mirror or doing embarrassing things that no one else should see, you do look away, right?
I can see into the furthest reaches of the world. I see the good and the bad, the beautiful and the abominable.
You saw me giving an imaginary harp concert in front of my mirror.
I count that amongst the abominable.
Okay, so sees through all reflective surfaces, such as a mirror, and I guess also still water, shiny metal, etc. And Mother and others summon you to ask your advice?
And Mother and others summon you to ask your advice.
I wouldn't exactly describe it as asking. They know how to reach me via one of the mirrors.
Hmm.
They want me to give them information, and if I don't answer, they just stand there and stare at me.
Hmm.
So you help them?
That is the question, is it not? Do I have an interest in supporting either one or the other side, or would I rather watch a catastrophe unfold?
So you'd pour oil onto the fire just because you want to watch the flames?
I could, but mostly I restrict myself to watching. I love to see how things develop. I can't abide when things come to a standstill. That's when I'm always tempted to give someone a shove in the right direction.
What do you know about the epidemic in Seastone?
There's talk of an epidemic in Seastone which is spreading. Do you know anything about it?
It is not an epidemic.
Well, what is it then?
It's something that you'll get involved
with. I'm sure.
Can you see into the future?
Stories repeat themselves. Other places, other participants, but the course remains the same. Good fights evil.
Well, I'm pregnant and shouldn't be. What do you know about it?
Why am I pregnant?
You are pregnant?
I thought you know all.
Should you not know that? You being the nearly all-knowing oracle.
I didn't see that. When did you get pregnant?
I didn't see that.
I'm asking you.
Stupid romance. A woodland glade, a bed in the cornfield, not a mirror in sight. Couldn't you and
Mate
have done that
somewhere
else? Done what? I knew she was going to say that.
Yes. Nothing at all, Princess.
Alright, I need the password of the shield guards.
I need today's password for the Woodland Realm Border Watch. Do you know it?
Of course. Your mother told the commander of the guards when she was standing next to the mirror surface of the moon well.
Can I have it?
Absolutely. I want to see how this develops. And there are quite a few surprises awaiting you in Seastone.
Okay.
Which, of course, you're not going to tell me about.
They wouldn't be surprises if I told you about them.
By any chance, is the password melon?
How do you know that?
Stories repeat themselves. Do you not know that? Thanks for that unsettling conversation. I have to go.
Yes, you must. Yes, but I didn't mean that. You will seek me out before this story ends.
You mean to say you will see me and follow my every move?
Yes, you will want to help a friend in need and won't know how to.
Really?
That's a different thing than what I said.
You will seek and find me. In a flying town, in a house with no corners.
Where will I find you?
Till then, Princess Ivo of the Woodland Realm.
Alright, messed up here.
But we will see each other again soon.
But, oh.
Text is messed up and in the way, the order of the dialogue. Interesting, though, huh?
I know everything I need to know. Today's password is melon. When I use it at the border, the watch will have to let me pass.
Right.
And by the time they find out they've been duped, I'll be in Seastone.
And that's just a matter of getting over there. Wilbur used the password melon for something. Can't quite remember. I don't know if it had to do something with the rat-hunting robot or something else. Anyway. Quite a long episode again. Thanks for watching. See you next time when maybe we get out of here, maybe not. And a bang bang boogie, and don't stop the boogie.